Hello students, good morning to all. Myself Devaraja Shubha, assistant professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Ponchasli College of Engineering. The subject code is C8702, Railways, Airport, Docks and Harbour Engineering. So today in this class I am going to discuss about defects in rails. So which comes under unit 1, Railway Planning and Construction. So what are the defects in rails? The 12 defects in rails are there. First one is the corrugated or roaring rails. Second one is corrosion of rails. And the third one is wear of rails. And the fourth one is crust head. And next one is the transverse fixture. Next, split head. Horizontal fixture. And the eighth one is square or angular bricks. Angular brakes. And ninth one is the hooked rails. The tenth one is the buckling of rails. And the 11th one is the creep of rails and 12th one is the kinks in rails. So these are the defects caused in rails. So let's see one by one. The first one is the corrugated or roaring rails. So usually the head of the rails are not flat. That is, it is in the shape of the wavy surface. So wavy surface is formed in the head of the rail. So that wavy surface is known as corrugated. So these rails, the wavy surface is formed in the surface of the rails, and these rails is known as corrugated rails. When trains pass through these corrugated rails, a roaring noise is produced in these rails. So that rails are said to be roaring rails. So what are the causes of these roaring rails or corrugated rails? Means it is due to the high speed and due to the coning of wheels are due to the dust or dampness or moisture in the atmosphere and due to the soft ballast, etc. So this is about corrugated or roaring rails. So next one is the corrosion of rails. So the rails are mostly corroded in the dampness area. So where the area is wet or where the area is moisture condition, in that area the rails are get corroded. So what we have to do is we have to avoid this corrosion, because if the corrosion occurs, what happens is the rail section will be get reduced and the strength also get reduced and the wear also get increased. If not prevented, what happens is lead to the failure of the rails. So to avoid or to prevent this corrosion of rails, what we have to do is we have to use the quality of the rail. That is, special alloy steel should be used in the manufacture of rails. Otherwise, we have to give the surface treatment. That is, we have to give coating. We can coat it with special paint, that red bitumen, red lead bitumen, etc. Coal tar, etc. we can use for the coatings. In India, what they are doing is, we are coating with zinc chromite on a priming coat of red lead. And after that, what they are doing is, they are coating with 3 coats of bitumen emulsion. So this is the surface treatment given to this corrosion of, where the rails are corroded. So that is about corrosion of rails. Next is about what is the wear of rails. So what is wear of rails? Moving of a number of wheels on the vehicle cause what is known as wear of rails. So this, according, depending upon the location, the wear of rails is classified into 3 types. That is, wear at head, wear at edges, and wear at sides. So wear at head means, in wear at head, what happens is the metal from the top of the head. So metal from the top of the head flows and forms a projection that is known as blur. So this is wear of rails at top position. Then in wear of rails at ends. So this is due to the expansion gap. If the expansion gap is there, what happens is the train move on that expansion gap, and due to the impact load produced by the train with the rails, what happens is the rails get veered. So next classification is the wear of rails at edge sides. So at sides, what happens is when the vehicle, that is when the train moves on the curve, when the train moves on the curve, what happens? Centrifugal force is developed on the vehicle. So due to this centrifugal forces, what happens is the side of the rail get veered. Okay, so this is the veer of rails. So next one is the crust head. So crust head means in the word itself we can understand what is crust head. So the head is get crust and the metal flows on the head of the rail is known as crust head. So this is due to the skipping of vehicles or slipping of vehicles, and it is due to the defect of manufacture. It is due to the skipping of vehicles and due to the defect of manufacture. So next one is the transverse fixture. So transverse fixture means the fixture is in the form of hole. It's in the form of fixture or hole, that is known as transverse fixture. So this is also due to the defect of manufacture or overstraining of the metal in service. So next one is split head. So from the word itself we can understand what is split head. Head is splintered. So the head is splintered into two parts, that is known as split head. So in this what happens is if the cracks are formed on the surface and when we open the rail, that rail is known as piped rail. That rail is known as piped rail. So next one is the horizontal fixture. So in this what happened is the fixture is for developed in the section of the rail and it goes on increasing. So first it occurs in a wire crack manner. So if not visible or if no treatment is given to that rails, what happens is it forms like a condor. So due to this also the rails will be get defective or failed. Next one is square or angular brakes. So braking. So brakes either in a vertical plane or inclined plane, that is square or angular brakes. So next one is the hooked rails. So hooked rail means the rails are hooked, bended. So the rails which are bent vertically at the ends is known as hooked rails. So this is due to the wear of rails at the ends. Next one is the buckling of rails. Here what happens is the formation of buckles takes place in the rails. Formation of buckles takes place in the rails so that the track go out of its original position. That is known as buckling of rails. So this due to this buckling of rails, derailment also happens. This is mainly due to the insufficient expansion gap in that area. If you are not providing sufficient expansion gap in that area, the buckling will happen, and due to this buckling, derailment also occurs. So this is a very serious effect. So next is a creep of rails. So creep of rails means longitudinal movement of rails in a railway track is known as creep of rails. Next one is the kinks in rails. So in this rails, so this is the longitudinal movement of rails. Here the adjoining rails move out of their position is known as kinks in rails. So this kinks in rails is caused due to the loose packing at joints and uneven wear, etc. So due to this what happened is unpleasant jerk when the vehicles move on these kinks. These kinks will be formed in this manner. So if these kinks are formed in rails and when vehicles move on these kinks, unpleasant jerk will be formed in the that is very unpleasant to the passengers who are traveling in the train. So these are about defects in rails. That is, then what are the defects of rails? Corrugated or roaring rails, corrosion of rails, wear of rails, crust head, transverse fixture, split head, horizontal fixture, square or angular brakes, hooked rails, buckling of rails, creep of rails, and kinks in rails. So next class we will discuss about the geometric design of railways. Thank you.